fifth graders, I'm Trent. In the fifth grade, you need to learn math concepts for many reasons. Concepts are big ideas. Understanding the big ideas will help you do well on the Ames test, get better grades in math, and prepare you for math classes in the future.
Plus, it is fun to solve problems and use parts of your brain you have never used before. When I solve a challenging math problem, it makes me feel great. I know the more I learn now, the brighter my future is. My name is Alexis. Let's get on with the show. We hope you enjoy
What's the Big Idea?
The big idea of this video is prime and composite numbers. Have you heard of them? We're not talking about primetime TV or a prime rib dinner. We're talking about prime numbers.
You will see these four vocabulary words hundreds of times before you graduate from high school. Prime, composite, factor, and multiple. The four words are related to each other. They're like one big happy family. Now here is our MVP Jonah, the math vocabulary person.
Thank you, Alexis. Let's talk about these four words. A prime number has exactly two factors, one and itself. A composite number is a number that has three or more factors. Factors are numbers multiplied together to get a product. Factors can be divided into larger numbers with no remainder. Multiples are whole numbers that are products of smaller numbers. Trent and Alexis will get into more details about primes, composites, factors, and multiple numbers now.
Thank you, MVP Jonah. Factors are numbers that are multiplied together to give you a product. In 3 times 4 equals 12, 3 and 4 are factors of 12. However, 12 actually has even more factors. Do you know all the factors of 12? Think about it.
In a quiet voice, tell your neighbor all the factors of 12, if you know them. Did you say 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, and 12? If you did, you are correct. One way to find factors is to think of multiplication facts. There are three whole number multiplication facts that equal 12. 1 times 12, 2 times 6, and 3 times 4. So 12 has 6 factors.
Multiples are different than factors.
Do you remember how to skip count? See if you can skip count by 12s in your head. Try to skip count by 12s in a quiet voice.
If you said 12, 24, 36, 48, 60, and so on, you just said some of the multiples of 12.
To find factors, you can use division or think about multiplication facts. To find multiples, either skip count or multiply.
So what do factors and multiples have to do with prime and composite numbers? Every whole number greater than 1 has 2 or more factors. The numbers that have exactly 2 factors are prime. The numbers that have more than 2 factors are composite.
2 is the only even prime number because all the other even numbers have 2 as a factor. There are a lot more composite numbers than prime numbers.
If we want to know if an odd number is prime, we have to decide if it has more factors than 1 and itself. Take the number 5. Is it prime? The answer is yes, because its only 2 factors are 1 and 5.
Take the number 15. Is it prime? In a quiet voice, tell your neighbor what you think. Is 15 a prime number?
The answer is no. 3 and 5 are factors of 15, so 15 is a composite number. Hopefully this is making sense to you.
With a partner, take 1 minute and see how many prime numbers you can write down on a piece of paper, from least to greatest. I'll get you started. 2, 3, 5, 7, 11. Now you keep going. We'll check your prime numbers in 1 minute.
time to see how you did. I'll start from the beginning. The prime numbers that have exactly two factors are 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, 17, 19, 23, 29, 31, 37, 41, 43, 47, 53, 59, 61, 67, and 71. If you found prime numbers greater than 71, you are an amazing math student. All the numbers between 2 and 71 that are not listed are composite numbers.
Today we talked about prime and composite numbers. Hopefully you saw the connection between factors and multiples with prime and composite numbers. Trust me, you will hear these four math vocabulary words from fifth grade all the way through high school graduation. What's the big idea? Prime and composite numbers.
Learning fifth grade math, big ideas, is awesome. We appreciate your attention and hope you like this video.
Math rocks. For Trent and MVP Jonah, I'm Alexis. See you next time on
What's the Big Idea?